Welcome, it's your friendly neighborhood Badger here, and I'm back for a video. Sorry I've been a little bit off on the videos the past few days because we've been playing BPL. I've been playing a lot and then sleeping and then jumping back up and playing. But BPL is in its last day. I think there's only about 19 hours left as of the recording of this video, and my goodness, things are going absolutely crazy. It's really close between the top two teams. I'm going to give a little bit of an overview of how things have gone so far, some interesting things that have happened, and we'll take a look at the website once again with all the ladder and everything like that. So let's jump to that right now, shall we? So as we can see here, the Druids are leading with 11,202 points right now. Close second is Mercenaries, my team, with 11,166 points, and the Knights are down below with 9,599. So as I said, really close between the top two teams with 19 hours to go, and we'll talk about the differences between the teams. But you can see a little bit of the point breakdown here. Druids are ahead in Delve and Bosses. They definitely scored the most points in Bosses. But Mercenaries have quite a few more gems and set points as well as of right now, and we can jump into that. Just talking about the ladder, first of all, we've got Huwu from Mercenaries up top with level 98, and then we've got Druids in the second, third, and fourth spot, and then a bunch more Mercenaries up there as well. So no Knights in the top 10, as you're seeing right here. But I think there's probably quite a few Knights here as well. Yeah, we got 12, 13, 15, and going down further as well. So let's talk a little bit about how these points do break down. Now the uniques themselves are a big part about all the points, all of the set points, which are the unique points here, unique sets. We can see here everything happening. So when it's green, the sets are fully completed. So Druids have completed 11 different sets, 11 out of 20, I think it is. 11 out of 20. Knights have completed 5 out of the 20. And Mercenaries have completed a 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So things are really close once again between the Druids and the Mercenaries. Most things are the same, apart from Mercenaries completing Bestiary, and the Druids have not completed Bestiary, and the Mercenaries have also completed the Uber-Elder and Expedition here as well. Now, if you scroll down a little bit further on the website, which I'll link down below if you want, you can search for any item. So if you want to see which teams have collected, say, for example, Amanamu's Gaze, we've got the Druids and the Mercenaries have collected Amanamu's Gaze, and the Knights have not collected it. So you can see it right there. You can also see the total down here of the number of uniques that have been collected per team. So that's actually kind of funny. There are 165 uniques on both Knights, both Mercenaries and Druids, but the reason that the Mercenaries are ahead is just because they've completed one more set first. So you get points for completing a set, being the first team to complete a set. So right now it's a bit of a rush for the rest of these, like the Betrayal, Labyrinth, Labyrinth I think is already done, and Betrayal as well. So things like Blight, things like Delve, things like Metamorph, Harvest, and Incursion, those are going to be the point breakers right there. All of the bosses have been killed, and Druids basically stomp the floor with everyone else, getting first place in Cirrus 5, Uber Itziri, Katarina I-83, and Uber Elder, and then coming second in Pure Kaula and Maven and Cirrus 9, and also first in the 70% quantity feared, so no third places. And so this is where we can see that Knights really dropped down some points, being third place in most of them, apart from second place in the Katarina I-83, with Mercenaries taking third place right there. And last of all, Heist. So Heist, Replica, Unique Collection, and Gem Collection is all over here. Now, I think there's a couple of bugs in terms of the gems collected. From what I know, it's confirmed that Knights actually have collected every single gem, every single alternate quality gem. Now, that's not every single version of each alternate quality gem. That's each gem with an alternate quality. So, say for example, if you've got a Winter Orb right here, you don't need Anomalous and Divergent. You just need, you know, any of the three types to score that one right there. And then collecting all of these. Now, obviously, something like Replica Headhunter is very difficult to collect. The Mercenaries have collected it. I think the other one being Congors, right? Yeah, Replica Congors Undying Rage is very, very rare, and no one has collected that one there as well. Now, if you want to search for anything yourself, you can definitely go and do so on the website. It's really fun to, you know, have a look through. And the last thing that I will mention is we do have a live coverage section on the BPL website. So you can see people who are streaming, who are playing in the BPL on here. So if you ever want to go and watch someone, they'll usually have, you know, what team they're on in their title here. So you can see next time around, we want to actually put the banner up here as well. So you can see straight away what these people are doing right here. So yeah, that's all I'll really say. It's insane, the amount of engagement and fun that people are having. If you've been having fun playing or watching BPL, please let me know down below in the comments. I'm having a ton of fun playing. I'm basically just going back onto stream now to grind some Blight, I think, for our team, trying to get some Blight uniques, but that's everything. So thank you so much for watching, guys, and until next time, Badger is waiting for you to subscribe.